everyone, and welcome to Pawfology. I hope you're all doing well. We have our tea right here, and this is a Tuesday Tea Talk. So welcome to Tuesday Tea Talk. I hope you're all having a good Tuesday. On Tuesday Tea Talk, we don't really talk about tea or drama. We just literally just talk while drinking tea. So that's what we're doing today.
Unless we do have drama to talk about.
Yeah.
Which we normally don't.
Yeah. No, we don't. So, Well, I do, I'm going to mention this before I forget, because I just need to say it now. A show I've been watching that is super amazing is Mayor of Eastwood, and I love it so much. It's on HBO, and I've seen it on HBO Max or whatever, you know, thinking, oh, I'll watch that at some point. But then I watched it while I was traveling, and it was so good. And I love it so much. It kind of has, it's just like a detective mystery show focused on Mayor, and she's from Eastwood. Oh, maybe it's Easttown, Mayor of Easttown. So That's all. I knew I would forget that because I've been thinking about it for the last two or three vlogs. I've been saying to myself, I need to mention that, but then I just forget every time.
I've heard somebody mention that they're watching that show and they really like it. It's called Mayor of Easttown, right?
Mayor, yeah.
You're not saying mayor?
No, not mayor. Mayor.
Mayor. Like M-A-R-E.
I think so, yeah.
Okay, that's what I thought.
That's just her name. Not mayor. Mayor.
Yeah, it's kind of a hard word to pronounce.
It is. It's a unique word, but I really do like it.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Do you think I would like it?
I don't know. It's a little dark. Mm. You know, it's a great show. I was talking to my friend Matthew about it. It's a great show to watch in the fall because just the colors of it and the feel of it is a very fall or Thanksgiving feel to it, you know?
And that is your favorite time of year.
Mm-hmm. But I couldn't wait. I just wanted to watch it. I don't really watch TV shows based on the season, but if you're someone who does that, there you go. That might be a good show to watch. And right now in the summer, a great show to watch is Red Oak. Red Oak is an amazing show on Amazon Prime, and it's a great summertime coming of age, nostalgic TV show. And I think it has about three or four seasons, and it's not really that popular, but I really liked it.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. A show that I am currently watching because season two just came out is Love, Victor.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
I watched season one at this time last year, I'm pretty sure, and loved it so much. Blew through all the episodes. I mean, they're only 20 to 30 minutes long, so it's easy to do.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, you know, I thought you watched that at one point, but I don't remember what it's about or anything like that.
Yeah, it's a kid in high school who comes out as gay, and just his experience like doing that with his family and his friends in high school and all the drama surrounding that. If you ever saw the movie Dear Simon, or maybe Love, Simon? I think it was called Dear Simon. It was a movie, though. I saw that in the theater with our friend Esther. Mm. It was really good. And then this is kind of like a spinoff from that movie, the show is. Because Victor is the kid's name. He will text Simon with like tons of questions about like what he should do in certain situations that are hard or challenging or like, you know.
Wow, I didn't know that.
Yeah, so it's kind of cool.
Is it on Hulu or something, or did you already say that?
It's on Hulu.
Oh, okay, interesting.
Yep. Hmm. So I started that on Sunday, and I'm like, I've already watched a lot of episodes, like seven.
Wow. Well, that's cool.
But they're so fast, and they're so good.
Mm-hmm.
I love teenager-y shows sometimes.
Yeah.
Another one that I like that is very similar is Never Have I Ever. And that's Mindy Kaling's show that she wrote and is executive producing.
Yeah. So is it like a coming of age feel? Is that what you mean? Or like,
well, they're in high school. Yeah. So I don't know.
Yeah. Maybe it's that. I don't know. I haven't seen.
You know, they go through all their high school stuff.
Yeah.
But it's like good for adults. obviously. It's not for teenagers. I don't think it's for teenagers. But yeah, so Mindy wrote it. She's one of my very favorite actresses and writers, and she, I think she's hilarious. So, and she, this is one show that she is not in. Like, she didn't write herself into the show. She just, like, wrote it.
What was that movie that Mindy had with the talk show host? Remember, did we see that together?
I know kind of what you're talking about. I can't remember.
It was just like Mindy was an intern for a talk show host, and she worked at a chemical factory and then went to intern with this talk show host. And it was basically like, you know, the talk show host was hated. And it just reminds me of Ellen's situation.
Oh, yeah.
But I think in that movie, the talk show host, you know, got her reign back or something. Or did Mindy take over? I don't remember.
I don't know. Maybe like when that other lady like was getting too old, she took over.
Yeah.
I really wish I remember what that was called.
Yeah.
Anyway. Yeah. So season 2 of Never Have I Ever is coming out in July. So I'll be excited for that too. I think it's fun when you wait around for like the next season and it's been a whole year since you saw it.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway. So I think we're both still tired from this weekend and from not getting hardly any sleep on Sunday night. I know I am.
Yeah.
I'm like still trying to catch up, but I'm so excited to sleep, but I have a lot to do before that time. I need to finish my homework for class tomorrow. I've read the 2 chapters that I was supposed to read, but I didn't like write my summary about it, and I need to review that. And then there's this article that is like 8 pages long that I need to read, and then also come up with like what are my key takeaways, because we always talk about that. It seems like in the class, if I know several of you were around when I was first starting this class, where I was worried about the professor doing like cold calling. So really, he's not doing that, but he would if we weren't all like already prepared with our key takeaways and like talking about how the book is integrating with the material and the article is integrating with the book. So I have to be prepared so that he doesn't cold call me. Also, last week while I was in Florida, I went to class because I have it every Wednesday, and participation is like 25% of the grade. So I didn't want to risk, you know, missing out any points for skipping class. I think you would have understood, but still, I was like, whatever, I can participate via Zoom. It's not that big of a deal. It's only 3 hours, 2.5. So first of all, we did breakout groups.
Oh, no way.
And our coaches came to class last week. They don't always come to class, but they are invited to. They're always invited, but there's specific ones where the professor wants them to be there. So my coaching group was in a separate, like, was in a breakout group. And so I texted my coach. I was like, okay, so do you want me to, like, send you a Zoom link so that I can join the group? Or because I'm not just going to be on the main Zoom in the classroom because they're leaving the classroom for the group.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, no, I will FaceTime you.
I would have done that. I would have just called, you know.
Oh, like on the phone.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that would have been so much smarter. But here I am. I wasn't on video Zoom. Like, I don't need the whole class staring at my face.
Oh, you weren't on video?
No, it's just, if you knew what the class looked like set up, you would understand. Like,
yeah.
The professor has me facing towards the class and not like at him.
Oh,
he's so like, I feel like it's much more important for you to see the class versus me. And I'm like, I can't even see the class really. I'm so far away. I'd rather see your face because you're the one talking.
Yeah.
I obviously didn't say that.
That's weird.
I know. But I was like, I am not turning video on. I was there the week before when another student was on Zoom and he turned his camera on part of the time. Which was fine, but it's like people are staring at you. Mm-hmm. And I didn't, you know, I just don't want that.
Yeah.
So, but then when my coach FaceTimed me for the group, I was like, well, this is unavoidable. I do not look fresh or professional right now. I went to the beach today. Mm. It was funny. And then, okay, I'm wrapping up this story soon. I'm sorry. This is a very prolonged class time story. And then I tried to participate in class and like give my two cents on something like he likes us to do. And so I unmuted myself and started talking. And then in the middle of it, I was like, can you guys hear me okay? Because I was just talking and I wanted to make sure like they can hear me. And so when I said that, the professor was like, okay, thanks, Emily. He was like, I think that was Emily. And the whole class laughed.
Oh, no.
So clearly my internet connection was not that great. And my voice was jumbled.
Yeah. No, the internet at this, you know, multi-million dollar beach house was horrible. It's like,
well, it's a rental, you know.
Still, you know, you can't get internet in that area, but whatever. I mean, I know I'm sure it's pretty common.
I'm sure they just chose like a low package because it's like you're not there to work.
Yeah, you're not exactly.
It was just so funny and kind of embarrassing. So I was like, oh, they definitely didn't understand anything I just said because I only said half of a statement. And he was like, thank you very much.
That's good. Well,
at least he knows that I tried.
Yeah.
And I emailed him. Mm-hmm. Anyway, so I've got class stuff to do tonight. I need to iron my clothes for tomorrow because I'm going to be in a workshop and it starts like, you know, early in the morning and I got to be prepared. Not very much of a morning person. I don't think either of us are really morning people. I mean, you get up early every day for work, but...
Yeah, I don't like waking up early. Mm-mm. But, you know, if I have to wake up, I'll just do it. It's not a problem. And it's not like I'm groggy or anything. I just don't like waking up. So
Michael will wake up and just be, like, wide awake immediately. Mm-hmm. I think it's so funny.
I'm just up. If it's 5 or if I got to be at the airport at 4, I'm up, ready to go. Mm-hmm. Just is what it is.
Are you a morning person or more of a night person?
Yeah, let us know in the comments below.
Yeah. So starting this week back at work, I'm in my new office. And it is so weird. Mm-hmm. I really miss my old pod and my old pod buddy. Mm-hmm. We saw each other in the morning yesterday, like, at the, you know, Monday, and we honestly almost cried.
Oh, my goodness.
I know that's drama, and I wasn't expecting it, but it's just, like, everything's going to be so different now because it was just us two in a pod together, and we, like, would just talk all the time, mm-hmm. like, or ask each other questions or an opinion on something. And so we both moved to different areas and it's just kind of sad. It's fine. I'm actually probably getting more done than I used to.
That's good.
Yeah. What else? Oh, this is funny. This is actually my last thing on my list. So I don't know if you guys can see my shirt. I think you can.
Yosemite.
I thought it said, for some reason, I thought it said Yellowstone. Clearly, I didn't read my own shirt. Okay, I knew it was one of those national parks. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I wore this shirt to work today, and one of my coworkers, I saw her in the main area, and she was like, oh, did you go to Yosemite? Like, so excited, and I was like, I had to say no, like, I got this shirt at Target. And then everyone around started laughing.
You got that at Target?
Yeah.
That's so funny.
I just like the shirt. It's cool.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, fun little funny, embarrassing moment of the day. It really wasn't that embarrassing. Everyone thought it was funny.
No, it is funny. Mm-hmm. I mean, Target sells a lot of different types of shirts, you know?
They do.
They got all types of stuff. There. Well, I don't really know if I have that much. I can talk about Virginia.
Yeah.
And reflect on Virginia. Going to Virginia was good. being with my parents was really good. I love being with them, especially hanging out with my mom and looking at her, all her plants and stuff. That, you know, that's just so fun. Especially, okay, a couple times she made her own salad out of her garden. She juiced. Yeah, it was really good, you know, and it's just a really special time to be with them. Actually, my mom has, what is it? It's pneumonia. My mom has pneumonia. Oh, yeah. And so she, you know, when I got there, she said she's been running a mild fever this whole time. Mm-hmm. So they went to Florida the week before, and she said she felt a fever coming on. Well, I guess by the time I left, she said she needs to go to the doctor. So she went to the doctor yesterday, and she was like diagnosed with pneumonia. And my mom has cancer in her lungs, so that doesn't help. So
no, not at all.
Yeah, they think it's in her right lung. So yeah, it's hopefully she'll be fine. She thinks she's gonna be good. So yeah, it's pretty crazy. Well, she has, so my mom has metastatic breast cancer, and it spread to the lungs and her spine and maybe somewhere
her
else.
Her legs. Kind of like in her hip area.
Yeah.
Of the bones.
So, but you know, she is as healthy as you can be dealing with that. Mm-hmm. So she's, you know, pretty happy person, likes her plants, likes just chilling, cleaning the house, you know, doing whatever. Keeps her occupied.
Nice.
So reading books and stuff. So it was all around just good time.
That's good.
So I hope to.
How was the weather?
It rained most days, actually. Mm-hmm. I could only look through my telescope one night. So
are you able to see anything interesting in your telescope?
Not really. I saw a bunch of stars, but because it's, I assume because it's June and where the planets are at, you can't, at least in Virginia where I was at, you couldn't see the planets and probably until 4 or 5 a.m. Mm. So specifically where I lived. So I guess maybe if you were somewhere else in the city or somewhere else, maybe you could, but you would have to wait a really long time. You can see some of the moon, but it's you got to look at it pretty early on or it goes below the trees. So I couldn't even see that. So, but, you know, I've been there a few times when I can see the moon and all the planets and they're right in front of me. So I don't know when I went, though. Maybe it was probably in December.
Yeah.
December, maybe August.
Yeah, we've been there mostly at the holidays, or we also went at the 4th of July.
Oh, yeah, we went, yeah.
But it's not like July's next month. It's only,
yeah, so it must have been December. But yeah, and being in Danville was interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing too interesting happened there, but
I liked when you went to Crema and Vine. I love that place.
Yeah, Crema and Vine was really cool.
I love getting coffee there. I like their pizza.
I really wanted to get, you know, I don't know if they serve Red Rooster coffee anymore. That was like their staple coffee that they, it's a coffee brand from Virginia, but I don't think they sell it there. Because normally they sell it by the bag and they, you know, they post on there what they're selling, but I don't know if they, maybe they just didn't have it that day or something. So, but no, Crema and Vine is always pretty nice. I got a pizza there. I got a coffee, listened to some live music.
That's fun. That sounds great.
Yeah. The guy named Dallas was singing. he was very
That's
interesting.
Classic.
He was pretty old. He was from Texas.
Shocking.
Yeah. Yeah. So it was cool. And yeah, Danville's really pretty. It's the nature there, just everything there is really beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
So it's always, and I didn't show this, but there's somewhere called the Million Dollar Road, and it's all these homes that were built in the 1800s or 1750s that are Million Dollar Homes. I think that's when they were built. No, probably 1900s. 1850 to 1900s. I don't actually know, but they're all these really old mansions, and and it's always pretty cool. You can go down there during Christmas and tour them and stuff. Really? Because people open up their homes. Yeah.
Oh, I want to do that.
It's kind of like that cookie tour we went on in Kankakee. But it's yeah. Danville. So like all
the holiday house walk.
Yeah. Yeah. So like these people that buy their homes and fix them up, invite locals to come in and tour it.
That's so fun.
Yeah. I always like doing that. Mm-hmm. So yeah. But,
cool.
I think that might be everything. Well, I have some random news unless you have anything else.
No, I don't. Nothing that exciting.
Okay, here is a quick fire random news segment.
Can't wait.
A lot of it is food related, but here's news that I found to be interesting. The first one is trolley gummies, you know, like the gummy worms. They're coming out with sneaker gummies. Interesting.
It looks like it's Space Jam themed.
Yeah, exactly. Space Jam themed. And, you know, there's a few other companies partnering with Space Jam, and they're coming out with cookies and stuff like that as well.
Nice.
So 7-Eleven is extending free Slurpee Day through the entire month of July. But I was reading their terms, and I think you can only get one free Slurpee for the entire month of July. So that didn't really make sense to me. You got to use their app to get the free Slurpee.
I see.
But that's so interesting because you can only get a small one, and the amount of data they're collecting from you from just downloading that little app is going to make up the cost, you know?
Yeah, that, no wonder they're extending the offer.
Like, yeah, download the app.
They can probably extend it for the whole year if you...
You download an app, you can anytime. Have a free Slurpee.
Yeah, but only once because we already have your data.
Yeah, exactly. Japan... has released an edible mask. It's made out of bread, and it's made out of melon bread.
Gross.
I know. And you know, I think you're only supposed to eat the part that's facing you, not the entire thing, because that'd be really gross because you're absorbing, imagine eating all that bacteria.
Oh man.
But for a pack of five, it's $16.44 USD.
That is very interesting.
Yeah. Starbucks is facing a supply chain shortage for a lot of their food flavorings, their venti cups.
I saw that.
Plant-based dairy options.
Wow.
Yeah, I thought that was interesting. Kit Kat has a new Kit Kat bar being released, if it's not already. It's fruity cereal. I would like to try that one.
That'd be good.
It looks like it's a Fruit Loop one. And then one of my favorite chocolate bar companies, Tony's Chocolony. They're coming up. They're coming out with four new flavors.
You've had Tony Chocolony.
Yeah.
Sounds like Tony Baloney.
Well, that is if it does. It's chocolate that fights against sex slavery and children. Slavery.
Wow.
Yeah. So, and they're found in most grocery stores.
Okay.
Like I think you can get it at Kroger. You can get it at every Whole Foods. I think you can get it at Meijer. So they're a cool company. I mean, some of their bars are pretty good, but they're coming out with a chocolate cookie caramel one, a milk chocolate hazelnut, a chocolate honey almond nougat, and a milk chocolate wafer and cookie pieces.
That sounds good.
You know, I do like their chocolate. I wish though they had a caramel filling or a filling chocolate, like a creamy filling inside, but none of them do. Even the nougat ones do not have that. NASA is planning to explore the dark side of the moon. Pretty interesting because they've never done that. And then the first seat of Blue Origin's Jeff Bezos' space mission sold for $28 million. So I think he has so many seats open, and it sold for $28 million.
That's
and
so
they're
crazy.
Meeting. I know the buyers are meeting with Jeff Bezos and his brothers next month to go over like the plan and stuff. That kind of sounds like a bad idea. I would not want to go to space with Jeff Bezos. You know, he doesn't know anything about flying up there. He's just hiring someone to do it. I would not trust him to do that.
No, I don't really want to go to space in general.
Yeah. You know, I kind of have a feeling it's just they're just going to leave the atmosphere barely, you know, mm-hmm. and they're not going to do anything that crazy. It's just
not going to land on the moon or something.
I don't think so, at least for the first flight, but maybe I'm wrong. I don't really know. Yeah. And then the last thing I have before we go, wait, do we need to do a comment down below?
Yes. If you're still watching, comment down below. Did you already say moon before?
I probably have, but okay. You can do moon again.
You can say moon or you can say spaceship.
Comment moon or spaceship down below, or use an emoji.
Yeah.
Whatever works for you. And then my last one is Apple hired a few of the ex-BMW and Faraday Future execs to their electric vehicle team. So now I probably wouldn't hire a BMW exec for an electric car company, but because their electric car didn't really do that good. But I will say the dashboard, which I think is what Apple's going to specialize in, BMW's dashboard and backup cameras is my favorite. I think they're amazing. So I love the setup of the BMW dashboard. I also like the Lexus one. They are very different, but I do love the BMW electronics, even though they might be, you know, whatever, but they're pretty nice. So yeah.
Cool.
Okay. That's everything. So we're going to go. Emily's going to work on her homework, I assume, and, you know, get through that.
Yes.
And I think that's everything. So I hope you all have a great Tuesday night, a great Wednesday. We'll see you tomorrow. You probably won't see Emily tomorrow. She has class. So, well, you'll see me tomorrow. You might see Emily. Who knows? If no one's told you this today, you are loved, and this world's a better place because you are here. We'll see you on Wednesday.
Bye.